शशिवर्णं चतुर्भुजं प्रसन्नवदनं ध्यायेत् सर्वविघ्नोपशान्तये सरस्वति नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणि विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम् श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहैः ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः
हरि
सो अकॉर्डिंग टू पूर्वपक्षी कर्म हैज टू बी परफॉर्म्ड थ्रू आउट लाइफ. If karma has to be performed all one's life, yavat jivam, then for who does Krishna enjoin dhyana? Who is supposed to do dhyana? Then Purvapakshi says, the karmi himself has to perform dhyana. Because everyone has to perform karma. Nobody can give up karma. Therefore, even the dhyana has to be performed by the karmi. That is how Purvapakshi establishes jnana karma samuchaya. Dhyana is nothing but abiding in jnana. And it has to be done by karmi. Thereby, jnana karma samuchaya is getting established according to Purvapakshi. Then Siddhanti refuted Purvapakshi's contention based on Shloka 3 of the chapter, Arurukshor Muner Yogam Ityadi. Now he is refuting Purvapakshi's contention based on a question by Arjuna at the end of this chapter. Arjuna talks about Yoga Bhrashta, whom he also calls by the word Ubhayavibhrashta. Siddhanti says, if a karmi is supposed to perform dhyana, then the question regarding yoga bhrashta and calling him ubhaya bhrashta does not hold good. Therefore, dhyana is not enjoined for karmi. Then Purvapakshi raised objection once again. Even though dhyana is done by karmi, the question regarding yoga bhrashta and calling him ubhaya bhrashta is meaningful, because this karmi, he is a mumukshu. Therefore, even though he is performing karma, he is not performing it for any other purpose. He is performing the karma only for the sake of moksha. Therefore, if he does not get moksha, if his efforts do not culminate in moksha, then he will become ubhayabhrashta. That was Purvapakshi's objection. Then Siddhanti said, it is not so, because moksha is not a phala. Moksha is not karma phala. Therefore, the karma which he has performed, whether he has done with desire or without desire, whether he has performed the karma as sakama karma or as nishkama karma, the karma should definitely yield its result. And that, therefore, the karma that he has performed will support him in the future birth. Therefore, he will not become ubhaya bhrashta. Siddhanti said this. Then Purvapakshi says, the nitya karma, which is performed with the Ishwararpana buddhi, it does not give phala, since it is offered to Ishwara, it will not yield phala in the form of better janma, etc. Then Siddhanti said, it is not so. The phala of the karma which is offered to Ishwara, it will have better result. Ishware sanyasasya adhikatara phala hetutvopapatti. The karma offered to Ishwara, it will have adhikatara phala. It will have better result. Then Purvapakshi raises objection once again. Mokshaya eva iti chet.
Mokshaya eva iti chet.
Svakarmanam kritanam.
Svakarmanam kritanam.
Ishvare nyasaha.
Ishvare nyasaha.
Mokshaya eva.
Mokshaya eva.
Na phalantaraya.
Na phalantaraya.
Yoga sahitaha.
Yoga sahitaha.
Yogaccha vibhrashtaha.
Yogaccha vibhrashtaha.
Ityataha,
ityataha, tam prati,
nasha shanka yukta eva iti chet,
nasha shanka yukta eva iti chet.
Purvapakshi says once again that the karma done for moksha will not give any other result. Already we have answered this in one way. But Purvapakshi raises similar objection once again. Then Siddhanti gives answer in another way. So, mokshaya eva iti chet, the karma performed by a mumukshu, it is mokshaya eva, it is only for moksha. Therefore, it cannot have another result, iti chet. This is Purvapakshi's objection. And he explains, svakarmanam kritanam, the karma performed by oneself, Ishvare Nyasaha, placing it on Ishvara, offering it to Ishvara. Mokshaya Eva, it is only for moksha. Na Phalantaraya, and it is not meant for any other result. Therefore, it will not give any other result. The karma which he performs, it is purely for moksha. And the karma will not give moksha all alone. It should be combined with yoga, dhyana, yoga sahitaha. Karma and yoga, they together give moksha. Now this person, he is performing karma for the sake of moksha. And along with the karma, he is also supposed to perform yoga. But he has become yoga vibhrashta. Yogacha vibhrashtaha. He has not done yoga properly. He has slipped down from the yoga. And if he has slipped down from the yoga, the karma also will become waste. Because karma cannot give moksha by itself. It can give moksha only if it is done with yoga. Now, since he has slipped from the yoga, not only he has lost the yoga, even the karma becomes waste. It is of no use. Ityataha, because of this reason, tam prati nashashanka yukta eva, tam prati, with reference to him, with reference to yoga bhrashta karmi, nashashanka yukta eva, nashashanka, the doubt regarding his nasha. Nasha means adhogati, adhogatyashanka, yukta eva, it is very much proper, even if you take the yogi as a karmi, the one who performs dhyana, even if he is a karmi, then also nashashanka is, can be explained, justified. Then Siddhanti answers this question, showing some other descriptions of a dhyana yogi, some descriptions of the person who is performing dhyana, given in chapter 6, indicate that he is not a karmi. Na,
na
ekakiyata cittatma,
ekakiyata cittatma,
nirashira parigraha,
nirashira parigraha,
brahmachari vratesthitaha,
brahmachari vratesthitaha,
iti karma sanyasa vidhanat,
iti karma sanyasa vidhanat.
Siddhanti says, na, it is not so. Dhyana is not mentioned for a karmi. And here we should also remember that an ideal karmi is a grihastha. Therefore, dhyana is not enjoined for a karmi. And dhyana is not enjoined for a grihastha. Those statements are correct. So it is not so. Why? Because in the chapter dealing with dhyana yoga itself, there is a description who should perform dhyana. Ekaki yata chittatma. He is an ekaki. Ekaki means alone. Alone means he does not have a family. Dhyana is not possible if one is in a family. No wife. He is ekaki. Yata chittatma. Nirashir aparigraha. And aparigraha, nirashihi, aparigraha. Nirashihi means he does not have any desires. Aparigraha, he doesn't have a possession. So, here ekaki, nirashihi and aparigraha are clear indications that he is a sannyasi. Therefore, dhyana is enjoined for a sannyasi, not for a grihastha. Therefore, dhyana yoga is not meant for combination with karma. Brahmachari pratesthitaha. Another statement which indicates that he is not a grihastha. He is a brahmachari vratesthitaha. He follows brahmachari vrata. Iti karma sanyasa vidhana. By all these statements, karma sanyasa is enjoined for a dhyana, for one who is doing dhyana yoga. Nacha atra
dhyana kale
stri sahayatva shanka
yena ekakitvam vidhiyate.
So purvapakshi me se, see, ekaki. See, in this ekaki yata chittatma nirashir aparigraha, there is the word ekaki. Siddhanti said ekaki is told, that means he has to be a sannyasi. Then Puravakshi says it is not so, because Krishna does not say always he has to be an ekaki. Other time he can have a family. But while doing dhyana, let him go to a room where he can close his door and do dhyana. At that time he is eka, he should be ekaki. That is the idea when Krishna says ekaki. By saying this, Purvapakshi is trying to justify dhyana for a grihastha, for a karmi. Then Siddhanti says, see, when somebody is doing dhyana, at that time he cannot interact with his wife or children. Even if a grihastha does dhyana, at that time he will be anyway ekaki. Because one cannot do dhyana along with his wife and children. It is not possible. Dhyana is alone, always. So, dhyana kale, at the time of meditation, he cannot have association with his family or wife. It is not prapta. At the time of meditation, association with the stree, etc., association with the wife, etc., it is not prapta. And if something is not prapta, it need not be negated. Praptasya nishedha. Apraptasya nishedha is redundant. Therefore, if Purvapakshi says the ekakitva is mentioned only during dhyana, it is not correct. Because during dhyana, ekakitva is anyway there. Anya sahaya or anya samsarga is not prapta at the time of dhyana. Therefore, it need not be negated by saying ekaki. Therefore, ekaki means his whole lifestyle, not just during dhyana. See, nacha, atra dhyana kale stri sahayatva shanka. Atra, in this statement, dhyana kale, at the time of dhyana, stri sahayatva shanka nasti. There is no fear of having stri sahaya, association with the stri, at the time of meditation. Yena ekakitvam vidhiyate, for which ekakitva has to be enjoined. So implying that the ekakitva is not just during dhyana kala, it is for all his life. He leads a lifestyle of ekakitva, not just during dhyana. He says, I will go in and do dhyana. It is not so. He is ekaki. So that means, if the word ekaki indicates that he is not a grihastha, therefore he cannot be a karma. Nacha grihasthasya nirashira parigrahaha ityadi vachanam anukolam
Ubhaya
viprashta prashnanupapattescha and also nirashihi and aparigrahaha, etc. Even they are not favorable if you take him as a grihastha. Grihasthasya, for a grihastha, nirashihi means free from desires. Aparigraha, he has no possessions. Ityadi vachanam includes brahmachari vrate sthitaha. Ityadi vachanam grihasthasya na anukulam. All these are not favorable to a grihastha. When a grihastha hears these things, he says, no, then I cannot meditate. So all these words exclude a grihastha. Ubhaya viprashta prashnanupapatteshcha. And also, ubhaya viprashta prashnanupapatti, the untenability of the question of ubhaya viprashta, even that indicates that it is not meant for a grihastha. For a grihastha, ubhaya viprashtatva is not possible, because he has karma to support him. So then Purvapaksha, Anashritaha ityanena Karminaha eva
Sanyasitvam
Yogitvancha uttam Pratishiddhancha Niraknehe
Akriyasya cha sanyasitvam
Yogitvancha
Iti chet.
Then Purvapakshi comes to the present shloka. Let us leave all the other discussions. What other places, what Krishna has told in other places we will need. In this shloka itself, shloka 1 itself, Krishna says, who is a sanyasi? A sanyasi is the one who does karma without depending on karma phala. By saying that, Krishna is also ruling out the sannyasitva of the person who has given up agni. And this is very favorable for the Purapakshi. With this Purapakshi says, there is no other sannyasa than grihastha sannyasa. If a grihastha performs the karma without expecting karma phala, that itself is sannyasa. There is no real sannyasa, means there is no regular sannyasa allowed in the Shastra. This is Purapaksha. Therefore, you cannot say that somebody gives up karma, takes to sannyasa and does dhyana. That argument is not possible, Purapaksha is saying. So this shloka is very favorable for Purapakshi. Anashritaha ityanena, by anashritaha etc. This shloka, karminaha eva sanyasitvam yogitvam cha uttam. Sanyasitva and yogitva, both are mentioned for a karmi only. And in the same shloka, na niragnyam na chakriyaha, by saying that Krishna has negated the sannyasitva and yogitva of one who has given up agni and one who has given up karma. So, na niragnehe na chakriyaha iti. By this statement, niragnehe akriyasya cha sanyasitvam yogitvam cha pratishiddham. The sanyasitva and yogitva of niragni and akriya is pratishiddha. So the Purapakshi is telling the Siddhanti, you have done a wrong thing by taking sanyasa. It is not allowed by Krishna. Who is a sannyasi? Grihastha is a sannyasi. Then Siddhanti says, Na. Dhyana yogam prati.
Bahirangasya satah karmanaha.
Halakamsha sanyasa stuti paratvat. It is not so, because this statement cannot be taken literally, because there are other places where regular sannyasa is also told. The real sannyasa is told in Bhagavad Gita itself, also in other shastras like Upanishads. The real sannyasa, when it is clearly stated in other parts of the shastras, Krishna cannot rule it out. Then why does he call a karma yogi as a sannyasi and a yogi? Then Bhagavan Bhashyakara says, it is meant for glorification. Why it is glorified? Because it is bahiranga sadhanam of dhyana yoga. It serves as a means to arrive at dhyana yoga. Therefore, it is glorified in the beginning of the description of Dhyana. So, no, it is not so, because Dhyana Yogam Prati Bahirangasya Satah Karmanaha. The karma which is Bahiranga with respect to Dhyana Yoga. The karma yoga which is a means to arrive at Dhyana Yoga. Therefore, it becomes Bahiranga, Bahiranga Sadhana. So, Sataha Karmanaha, that is karma. Palakanksha Sanyasa Stuti Paratva. So, this shloka, it is meant for stuti, stuti paratvat. It is meant for stuti of the phalakanksha sanyasa, giving up of the phalakanksha, giving up of the desire for result while performing the karma, which is bahiranga for dhyana. So, this cannot be taken literally. It is a stuti. And he explains what Krishna is trying to say in that shloka. Na kevalam,
na kevalam,
niratnihi akriyah eva sanyasi yogi cha.
Niratnihi akriya eva sanyasi yogi cha.
Kim tarhi,
kim tarhi,
bhavati,
bhavati,
karma phala sangam sanyas, sorry, kim tarhi,
kim tarhi,
karmi api,
karmi api,
karma phala sangam sanyasya,
karma phala sangam sanyasya,
karma yoga manutishthan,
karma yoga manutishthan,
sattva shuddhyartham,
sattva shuddhyartham,
sa sanyasi cha yogi cha bhavati,
sa sanyasi cha yogi cha bhavati,
iti stuyate,
iti stuyate.
So na kevalam niraknihi akriyah eva sanyasi yogi cha. So one who is nirakni and akriyah, only such a person is not a sannyasi and yogi. Means the sannyasitva and yogitva do not belong to only a niragni and akriya. Kim tarhi, then what? Karmi api, even a karmi. Karma palasangam sanyasya. If he gives up karma phala sangha, if he gives up desire for karma, and karma yogam anutishthan, performing karma yoga, he performs karma yoga, giving up the desire for result. And why does he perform karma? Sattva shuddhyartham. Sattva shuddhyartham karma phala sangam sanyasya karma yogam anutishthan. Saha sanyasi cha yogi cha bhavati. Even he is sanyasi and yogi. Iti stuyate. In this manner, a karmi is glorified. So this shloka is meant for glorification of a karma yogi. And it is not meant for ruling out the sanyasitva and yogitva of the regular sanyasi. Then Purvapakshi may say, why can't we take it as both? The same shloka glorifies a karma yogi and the same shloka negates the sannyasitva and yogitva of a real sannyasi, regular sannyasi. Why can't we take it as both? Because in the same shloka, na niragnirna chakriyaha, it is told. One who is niragni and akriya, he is not a sannyasi. It is also told. Then Siddhanti says, see, Siddhanti brings a dosha, a fallacy in the interpretation of a statement. In the Mimamsa Shastra, an interpretational fallacy is accepted. It is called Vakya Bheda. Vakya Bheda Dosha. When a single sentence gives two different messages, then it is called Vakya Bheda. If you derive two messages from one statement, then it is called Vakya Bheda. And this dosha is based on the idea that one statement should have only one purport. One statement cannot have two different purports. Therefore, if you say a single statement gives two different messages, then there is a fallacy called Vakya Bheda Dosha. Therefore, if Purvapakshi says that this shloka, it is glorifying a karma yogi, in the meantime it is giving another message also, that is in the form of negation of the sannyasitva and yogitva of a regular sannyasi, then it will have Vakya Bheda Dosha. Therefore he says, Nacha ekena vakyena,
Nacha ekena vakyena,
Karma pala sanga sanyasa stutihi,
Karma pala sanga sanyasa stutihi,
Chaturthashrama pratishedhascha,
Chaturthashrama pratishedhascha,
Upapadyate,
Upapadyate,
Ekena vakyena, by one statement, Karma phala sanga sanyasa stutihi. So the glorification of karma phala sanga sanyasa, giving up of desire for karma phala. This is one message. And another message is chaturthashrama pratishedha. Chaturthashrama means sanyasashrama. Tasya pratishedha. Both cannot be possible. Both cannot be justified from the same vakya, as the message of the same vakya. Ekena vakyena, these two things are not reasonable. Na upapadyate. Because if you take two messages, then it will bring about Vakya Bheda Dosha. So this is one reason why we cannot accept the shloka to mean the negation of the real sannyas. And he gives another reason also, why Krishna cannot rule out the regular sannyasa. Nacha prasiddham,
Nacha prasiddham,
Niragnehe akriyasya,
Niragnehe akriyasya,
Paramartha sannyasinaha,
Paramartha sannyasinaha,
Shrutismati Purane Itihasa Yoga Shastreshu,
Shrutismati Puraneshu Itihasa Yoga Shastreshu,
Vihitam Sanyasitvam,
Vihitam Sanyasitvam,
योगित्वञ्च
योगित्वञ्च
प्रतिषेधति भगवान्
प्रतिषेधति भगवान्.
See, the regular sanyasa is told in many places of the Shastra. First of all, it is Shruti Vihitam. It is there in the Shruti. There are many Shruti Vakyas which are in favor of sanyasa. Like Brahadaranyaka Upanishad says, Putreshanayascha Vitteshanayascha Lokeshanayascha Vyutthayatha Bhikshacharyan Charanti. Then Jabal Upanishad, Brahmacharya Deva Prabrajet Brihadvavanadva Yadahareva Virajet Tadahareva Prabrajet. So there are many Shrutis in favor of the regular sannyasa. Regular sannyasa means sannyasa which involves giving up of karma, karmatyaga, karmatyagatmaka sannyasa. And not only Shruti, there is Smrti also, many Smrti Vakyas. If you take Manusmrti or any other Smrti, there also sannyasa is mentioned. And Purana, even Purana, there is sannyasa told. And Itihasa, Itihasa means Ramayana and Mahabharata. Both in Ramayana and Mahabharata, you will find the mention of regular sannyasis. Purana and Yoga Shastra, there are many Yoga Shastra books. So even they talk about sannyasa. Yoga Shastreshu. See, all these are pramana. Shruti, Smrti, Purana. Even Purana is pramana. They are secondary pramana. Shruti is primary. Secondary is Smrti. Even Itihasa comes under Smrti only. It's a category of Smrti. We consider Itihasa as equivalent to Smrti. Then third level is Purana. So if there is a virodha between Shruti, Smrti and Purana, first we have to consider Shruti. Then we have to consider Smrti and then we have to consider Purana. If a Purana statement is not in keeping with the Shruti or Smrti, then the Purana statement has to be interpreted in such a way that it is in alignment with Shruti and Smrti. It does not contradict, it should not contradict Shruti and Smrti. Vihitam sanyasitvam yogitvam cha. So in all these shastras, a Niragni and Akriya, he is mentioned as a Paramartha Sanyasi, a true Sanyasi, a real Sanyasi. And for him, Sanyasitva and Yogitva is also mentioned. Prasiddham, it is Prasiddha in Shruti Ityadi. And Bhagavan cannot negate that. Na Bhagavan Pratishedhati. Because even Bhagavan has to speak based on other Pramanas. He is not inventing a new religion. Somebody was telling Krishna invented a new religion. He did not invent a new religion. Krishna spoke what is there in the Veda. His words are based on Shruti Pramana. So he is not saying something which is not there in the Shastra. So Nowadays people think everyone has to be a revolutionary. Krishna is not a revolutionary. He did not say, I am nullifying the Vedas and I am starting a new religion, new ideas. Not so. So, Bhagavan cannot negate that. And one more reason why it is not negation of the regular sannyas.
Svavachana virodhaccha
sarva karmani manasa sanyasya naiva kurvanna karayannaste
mauni santushto yena kenachit
Aniketa sthiramatihi Vihaya kamanyas sarvan Umashcharati nisprahaha Sarvarambha parityagi
Iticha
Tatra
Bhagavata
Svavachanani pradarshitani Tair virudhyeta Chaturthashrama pratishedaha Svavachana virodhaccha So if Purvapakshi's interpretation of the shloka is taken, what is Purvapakshi's interpretation? The shloka negates regular sannyasa. And the regular sannyasa is called Chaturthashrama or Turiyashrama. It is the regular sannyasa. After Brahmacharya, Garhasthya, Vanaprastha, then fourth ashrama is sannyasa. So if we accept the shloka as Chaturthashrama Pratishedha, then Svavachana Virodhat. It is not correct. Chaturthashrama pratishedha paratvam of the shloka is not correct because svavachana virodhaccha. It will contradict Krishna's own statements in other parts of the Gita. Svavachana virodhat. Sva means Krishna. His vachana will be contradicted. And where are the statements made by Krishna favoring sannyasa, favoring the regular sannyasa? Sarva karmani manasa sanyasya naiva kurvanna karayannaste. This is one statement in support of the regular sannyasa, which involves karmatyaga. Naiva kurvan nakarayan asti. Then mauni santushto yena kenachit aniketa sthiramatihi. All such descriptions of a jnani are found. Mauni. A jnani is referred to as mauni. So a grihastha cannot remain mauni for long. So mauni means he has dropped all complaints. Mentally he is in mauna. No complaints, no responsibilities. Santushto yena kena chit. He is satisfied with whatever he gets, yena kena chit, with a little bit. He does not have any compulsive likes and dislikes. I want this, I want that. He cannot say. Yadrachalabha santushtaha. Aniketa sthiramatihi is aniketaha. He does not have a house, home, no home. Sthiramatihi. And vihaya kamanya sarvan pumascharati nispraha. So he gives up all desires and nispraha charati. He moves around without any desire. Sarvarambha parityagi. He has given up all karmas. Iti cha, in this manner, tatra tatra, here and there, Bhagavata svavachanani pradarshitan. Bhagavan has shown his own words where he has talked about karma sanyasa, which is in the form of the regular sanyasa. Taihi viruddheta chaturthashrama pratishedha. So chaturthashrama pratishedha contradicts these statements. Taihi viruddheta, it will be opposed to these statements. Tasmat
munehe
yogam aru rukshoho
pratipanna garhasthasya
garhasthasya agnihotradikarma
Phala nirapeksham
anushthiyamanam
dhyana yoga rohana sadhanatvam
buddhi shuddhi dvarena
pratipadyate iti
Sa sanyasi cha yogi cha Iti stuyate So tasvat, therefore. So now Bhashyakara is concluding the discussion by saying the purport of this shloka. The shloka is not meant for chaturthashrama pratishedha. Instead, it is meant for karma yoga stuti. So, munehe yogam arurukshoho. Yogam arurukshoho munehe. A muni, a mumukshu, who wants to get into yoga, means who wants to qualify for dhyana yoga or jnana yoga. Pratipanna garhasthyasya, and he has taken to garhasthya, he has taken to grihasthashrama. Because he knows that he cannot take sannyasa directly, though he wants moksha, ultimately. He knows that garhasthya is the right thing for him. Agnihotrani karma. The karmas like agnihotra, etc. Karmas beginning with agnihotra, etc. Agnihotrani. So, Agnihotrani Ashwamedha Paryantam Karma. The Shauta Karma start with Agnihotra. Agnihotra is the basic type of Shauta Karma. So, then there are higher karmas, bigger karmas like Jyotishtoma, Agnishtoma, etc. Finally, the greatest karma is Ashwamedha. Agnihotradi karma. phalanirapeksham anushthiyamanam. If it is performed without desire for phala, dhyana yogarohana sadhanatvam buddhishuddhidvarena pratipadyate iti. Buddhishuddhidvarena, by means of buddhishuddhi, dhyana yogarohana sadhanatvam pratipadyate. It becomes a sadhana for dhyana yoga arohanam. It becomes a sadhanam for getting into dhyana yoga. Iti, because of this reason, Krishna glorifies karma yoga. Sa sanyasi cha yogi cha iti stuyate. Sa karma sa sanyasi cha yogi cha iti. Agnihotradi karma. Phalanirapeksham anushthiyamanam agnihotradi karma stuyate. The karma which is performed without a desire for result, it is tuyate, it is glorified. Why? Because it is a means for dhyana yoga. Anashritaha iti. So now he starts explaining the shloka proper. So far it was introduction to the shloka. Now the shloka is being explained. Anashritaha.
Anashritaha.
Na ashritaha anashritaha.
Na ashritaha anashritaha.
Kim.
Kim.
Karma phalam.
Karma phalam.
Karmanaha phalam.
Karmanaha phalam.
Karma phalam yat.
Karma phalam yat.
Tat anashritaha.
Tat anashritaha.
Karma phala trishna rahitaha ityarthaha.
Karma phala trishna rahitaha ityarthaha.
Yohi karma phale trishnavan.
Yohi karma phala trishnavan.
Karma phala trishnavan or karma phale trishnavan. Both are okay. Karma phala trishnavan is also fine. Saha karma phalam ana ashrito bhavati.
Saha karma phalam ashrito bhavati.
Ayantu tadviparitaha.
Ayantu tadviparitaha.
Ataha.
Ataha.
Anashritah karma phalam.
Anashritah karma phalam.
Anashritah. Na ashritah anashritah. He is not dependent. Ashritaha means dependent. One who depends is called ashritaha. Na ashritaha anashritaha. He is not ashritaha. Nanya tatpurusha. Kim karma phalam. Kim anashritaha. What he does not depend on? Karma phalam. Karmanaha phalam karma phalam shashti tat purusha. Karma phalam yat tat anashritaha. He is not dependent on karma phala. That means karma phala trishna rahitaha ityarthaha. The implied meaning of karma phalam anashritaha is karma phala trishna rahitaha. He does not have desire for karma phala. Ityartha. So how do you get this meaning? Karma phalam anashritaha means karma phala trishna rahitaha. How do you get this meaning? Because one who is having a desire for karma phala, he is dependent on karma phala. That means he does karma, being dependent on karma phala. His mind is fixed on karma phala, and that is what motivates him to do karma. So that is how karma phala ashraya is connected with karma phala prashna. The desire for karma phala is associated with dependence on karma phala. So his action as well as the satisfaction born of the action both depend on karma phala for one who has desire for karma phala. So yohi karma phale trishnavan. Yaha karma phale trishnavan. If one has trishna for karma phala, desire for karma phala, saha karma phalam ashrito bhavati. He becomes dependent on karma phala. Always he is thinking of karma phala. And his actions depend on karma phala. Ayanto tad viparitaha. This person is not so. His actions are not dependent on karma phala. Instead, his actions are determined by what he is supposed to do. His dharma. Ataha anashritaha karma phalam. Therefore, he is karma phalam anashritaha. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.